What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Prosper back with another reaction video. In this video, where I'm about to react to The Roots, what they do. Shout out to John and Brian for requesting this shit. I'm familiar with Black Thought as far as like his solo projects and whatnot. I heard a few of his songs and a lot of his features, and he kills them, bro. He's dope. He's one of a kind when it comes to this rap and shit. Definitely top five lyricist in my opinion, ever to do it. But yeah, I'm ready to see what this shit's all about. Like I said, I heard his solo shit, but I've never heard his stuff with The Roots. And I feel like this might be his best work, since it's his earlier work, and that just tends to be the case with a lot of these older artists and whatnot. But I heard a lot of people say, like, he doesn't have a specific year where he was in his prime, because he's been in his prime his whole entire career. You know what I mean? He hasn't lost it at all. So yeah, I'm ready to see what this shit's all about. This is one of their biggest songs. I'm not going to react to the music video because YouTube be blocking the music videos. I just learned that now recently. Like the last five reactions I did to music videos of old school songs, all of them got blocked. So I'm just going to be reacting to the audio and whatnot. And I feel like that might be better just because sometimes the music video censors the curse words and whatnot, and that shit just sounds terrible. But yeah, I'm ready to see what this shit's all about. But before we get into the video, I'm gonna need y'all to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, roach 100k subs, let's get it, let's go. Post notifications on. And with that being said, let's check this out. What's dope too is like the beats that they use, since it's like a band, you know what I mean? Most of their shit they could perform live, and it just sounds good being performed live. I know they're on Jimmy Fallon, I believe. That's where they do their performances and whatnot. Not performances of their own songs, but that they're there just, I don't know what they do, but that's where a lot of people know them from, especially me.
Generation, fast-paced nation, world population confront their frustration. The principles of true hip-hop have been forsaken.
That's it's facts. All
contractual and about money making. Pretend to be cast, don't seem to know their limitation. Exact replication. And
hold up, for one thing about him though, bro, is I don't know what it is about him. It's just he's a dope ass rhymer. I know there's so many greats that are great at doing the multi-syllables and whatnot, but he's just so like, he does it, his delivery is just so cool, you know what I mean? But, like, he's saying some real ass shit in the song, bro. It's crazy. This shit came out in 96, and the mainstream music has always been about the money making songs, you know what I mean? The flex talk. So, like, the principles of true hip hop have been forsaken. It's all contractual and about money making, which is facts. But, like, this came out before I was born, so I don't remember any of that shit, because it was before my time. But it's just, it seems like this message is relevant now, but it's been relevant for many years. Like, the mainstream shit is always the dumbed down shit.
Representation, you want to be a man that stands your own. To MC requires skills, I demand some show. I let the frauds keep fronting and roam like a cellular phone far from home, giving crowds what they wanting. Official hip hop consumption, the fifth thumping, keeping your party jumping with an original something. Yo, I dedicate this to the one dimension now, no imagination, excuse for perpetration. My man came over and said, Joe, we thought we heard you. Jokes on you, you heard a bite and ass true, but
that's dope. Who is he talking about? Because that seems like a shot right there. I don't know if it's a shot or nothing, but he's just basically saying this is dedicated to the niggas who are one-dimensional. You know what I mean? That one-dimensional, just talking about the same shit, doing the same shit. No imagination, excuse for perpetration. But what I don't know who he's talking about. Talking about a crew biting him. I don't know if it's directed at a specific crew back then, or it's just in general the message talking about how everybody takes from other people and whatnot. This hook is dope, bro. And it's fast, bro. Never do what they do. Because you know what I mean? Like, often peer pressure, people, your peers will pressure you into doing what they do. And it might not always be the best, especially if they're peer pressure you to do it. You know what I mean? Because think about it, niggas, I learned this shit in college, bro. Like, when I was in college, bro, niggas would be quick to just offer you drugs, would offer you alcohol and whatnot. But they will never offer you money to go get food, bro. So they'll be quick to offer you the shit that's bad for you, but they will never be quick to give you the shit that's good for you. Like, they will never lend you money or whatever. These so-called friends of yours. And I caught on to that shit. That shit just, I was like, damn. Like, it just puts everything into perspective. You think that he's your friend because he's putting you on to drink or whatever, but not really, bro. You could fall for peer pressure, bro. That shit's crazy. But yeah, I fuck with that. It's a simple ass hook, but it's just, it hits home.
And hatred. That's the game is ill natured, it's nothing sacred. And yo, it's funny what I see some rap niggas do to make it. A few will blow up or go as far as they can take it. My 9 to 5 is just to hit you, get the party live. I'm Black Thought, used to rap for sport. Now the rhyme saying rent, paying life support. I take it very seriously. Within this industry, it's various crews to try to touch me. But I come with the beautiful things, and I bless the track lushly.
Bro, I'm saying, like, he just got a one of a. Like, it's not even. He doesn't even have to rely on flow. Some people just have to rely on flow, but he just has this cool delivery, but he says some real ass shit as well, which is fire as hell. But like, one thing he touched on is Ayo, it's funny what I see some rap niggas do to make it. A few will blow up or go as far as they can take it. You know what I mean? One thing that I noticed is he should be so big. But the reason he's not big, bro, is because he's never... It seems like he never sold out, you know what I mean? A lot of people sell out, especially in the rap game. And he just stayed true to lyricism. He stayed true to what hip-hop is. And that's why he's... I wouldn't say he's not recognized or whatever, because he does get some recognition, but he gets overlooked a lot. He definitely should be in the discussion. Undebatable. You know what I mean? So it's crazy. The world crowds love me from doing tours. Recipient of applause from all of you and yours. Creator of original sounds that's in the stores. You take home to absorb and sweat it out your pores. Now who can stop the music running through these veins? Infinitely go against the grain. That's why my motto is too. He's too cold, bro. He's too cold. This hook is fire, bro.
The life of limos and lights, airplanes and trains, short days and long nights, keyboards and mics, bass chords and drum kicks, in my mental deck they hit my head like brick, as I embark on a mission, welcome into the dark, when I first spark the arts, when the listening start, open your head wide, and let the thought inside, my style fortified by all of Philadelphia, my delph more stuff than all the wicked wealth, mentality undetectable by the naked eye, dick, I get paid when the record is played, to put it short, I want it made like Ed, no said. Then after that, I'm putting on my cousin Hamed. We let the ladies blend with the dark skin devil bread and discover my level is that of no other. And Roots Crew reign official and true while I'm continuing to.
This shit is fire, bro. This shit is fire, bro. It's so chill. It's a chill ass song, bro.
Yeah.
beat is nice too, bro. I think this is gonna play out like this shit. This is fire, bro. This shit is hard, bro. The beat is hard, bro. It's dope. It's just a chill ass beat. That shit dope, bro. I don't know if they, like, use live instruments, you know what I mean, to make the music and whatnot. It seems like it, because I hear a couple live instruments in that beat and whatnot. But that shit was dope, bro. That shit was fire as hell. And what I mean by that, it's not like other producers and whatnot using just sounds from the computer and whatnot. I feel like they actually pick up instruments and shit and just come up with the song and whatnot. That shit is fire though, bro. Like, he's cold, bro. He's cold. Just a simple way to put it. But yeah, he's killing that. He killed that shit. I like the line where he said, "There's a thin line that run between love and hatred," which is so true. It's like a really thin ass line. And then he's just talking about how the rap game is just changed. Hip hop has been forsaken, all about money talk and whatnot. Talking about how people will do anything just to blow up. Nowadays, it just, you see it, bro. All the gimmicks. It's only gimmicks, bro. No talent, simply gimmicks. Which is, social media helped a lot of people, you know what I mean, that rely on gimmicks. Because if it wasn't for social media, them niggas wouldn't be here. But this shit was fire, bro. I like how he enunciates words, too, just to make them rhyme and whatnot. That shit's fire, bro. The beat was dope. It was a chill-ass song overall, bro. I fuck with it. The hook was a simple-ass hook, but it's a meaningful message, bro. Like, dead ass. It's a dope-ass message that everyone could relate to. And it's positive. It's a positive message. Never do what they do. You know what I mean? Simple as that. Because what they do might not be good. But that shit was dope. I fuck with it. I'm definitely going to react to more of their shit. Request more of their stuff down below. Or I'll just go through their big songs and whatnot. It's a shame that this shit only got 15 million views on Spotify though, bro. It's shit like that that makes me mad low-key. You know what I mean? Because I know it's a different time period and whatnot. But still, it should definitely be in the 100 millions and whatnot. Because this shit's a classic, bro. This shit is fire. But yeah, if y'all enjoyed my reaction video, be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe, turn post notifications on, share the video, do all that fun stuff. And with that being said, I'm gonna see y'all next one. I'm out. Peace.